A lot of concern about a potential price bubble here that could derail the world's second biggest economy. You're not concerned. Why is that?
Well, I'm not concerned in the near term. I think if we sort of describe the near term as the next 2 years, it's very unlikely to be all that problematic. First, the Chinese themselves realize that their extension of credit in the system has been extraordinary and are sort of working on delevering the system. They have one of their foremost technocrats in Guo Suching, you know, sitting on top of the issue now, and we think that that's really been likely to be the platform to have Guo promoted to be the next PBOC head. So the first part is that they have a generalized awareness of it. The second is we just started the mixed-use ownership scheme of SOEs. I basically think we're in the first inning of that scheme, and whether or not the new scheme will be successful over a five-year period, I think that remains to be seen. But the new scheme basically brings private sector capital into SOEs, and in fact, in doing so, you're basically, the Chinese are de-levering, or rather de-risking the system through that channel initially. And then the third part is, you know, the Chinese are going to come to market literally within days in the dollar bond market again as a sovereign. The Chinese aren't coming to issue $2 or $3 billion of debt for their own purposes. What they're doing is creating a current benchmark where you're going to start to see a number of the SOEs in the system be able to issue on top of the sovereign and in fact bring their credit costs down. So all of these forces in the near term, next 1 to 2 years out, I don't think the China credit issue is an issue for global markets.